Mike, check, 1, 2, 1, 2. I want to welcome everybody back to episode 11 of Barcast. Let's play that shit real quick. All that. Play all the drops you need to play. I am, as always, your moderator, Mr. Know-It-All. Without further ado, pass it off to the host, Ain't Shit B. Will, the therapist in the building.
Yeah. Yes,
all
sir.
Right, all right, introduce yourselves, and we got some guests with us today. Introduce yourselves, ladies.
Who going first?
Star.
Star who?
The best.
Star the best.
Kinda. I'm the
star. Uh-huh.
And it's Party Bob.
That's it.
We know you. You've been here before.
A repeat offender.
Welcome back. We appreciate you. All right, man. Steve is in the building. Shout out. He ain't doing this thing right now. Every Monday night, Crush Lounge. What's the address?
6414 Rising Sun Avenue.
We talk about love, life, relationships, sex, and all that shit. Make sure you out here, you come through or whatnot. We do what we do.
On all platforms.
We on all platforms.
I'm gonna make sure I do the Steve.
All right,
every now and again. Yo, right. Crush Lounge, you know, get a drink, buy a drink, y'all. You know
what I mean? Tip your ball to this. All right, y'all. I'm gonna start off with a question real quick. I'm gonna let y'all have at it. One mic at a time, one person talking at a time. We're gonna have a great, great conversation, all right?
Yes.
My first question is that in a relationship with a significant other, who comes first? If you marry?
Your wife.
No, who comes first?
Right now.
No, not that type of come. Wow, wait a minute. Let me finish the question. You niggas is nasty. Everybody on their freaky deaky. Hold up. No. Who comes first? The mother, the wife. That is a good question. The mother, the wife, or the child?
The wife.
All of y'all agree?
Yeah, I'm going through that right now. Like, that's just how. I mean, once that woman takes her vows to that man, or to that man, that significant other, that's who comes first.
Yes.
Even though some of us don't agree with it. But that's how it goes. Like, the husband comes first, the wife comes first, then it's the boom, 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 you follow up.
Agreed. I think when you get married, you know, your dad's walking her down the aisle to give to you.
Her dad.
Her dad's walking her down the aisle to give to you. You feel me? And now she becomes the queen. That doesn't mean you don't respect your mom, but she's the queen of your castle.
Right.
You feel
right.
me? I'm the king, she's the queen.
Right.
She has number one say. Period. You feel me?
Nah, I agree with that.
That doesn't mean you can just disrespect my mom now. You
right,
feel me?
Right,
we're
right.
not saying that. We're right, not saying right. you could just disrespect my mom. But what I'm saying is, in a healthy relationship,
right.
I feel like if I'm building with you,
right.
you come before my mom, because my mom has her castle. Well, she's supposed to.
Right.
She's supposed to have her castle with my dad or with whoever man that she's building with.
Right.
She's supposed to be queen of that castle, not my castle.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So if I'm building my kingdom, my queen comes first.
Anybody feel different about that?
Oh my God, you so mature today.
I know, it's crazy, right?
Yeah, man,
it's a thought process. Yeah.
Give him a fucking air horn.
He went to church Sunday.
Oh, is that what it was?
He had to. Or he took his grandma to the market.
That's what it was. So, that's what it was. Star, you feel the same way?
100%. I'm a wife, kinda, I guess. I don't know. But yeah, you definitely put your spouse first.
So
I'm gonna struggle with who come before the mom or the kids because the husband is first.
I think once we have kids, the kids are number one. It goes kids, wife, mom, this. But
oh no!
I feel like
wait a minute.
Why? I feel like.
I'm always going to love my kids more than anybody in the world. That means my wife, too.
But I feel like it shouldn't even... Once the husband or the wife comes first, there's no level, because it's supposed to be understanding that the kids don't even have to be on the chart, because they in here, we taking care of them regardless.
I agree.
So they're just there. They're not even on the chart. So we can just skip the kids. It's the mother. It's the wife. It's not skipping the kids. It's just like... A bill. You ain't skipping that bill, your ass getting kicked out. Kids is there, they stare. That's what it is. You know what it is, what we gotta pay for, how we gotta take care of
it. Say what you gonna say.
That's definitely not true. And a lot of marriage counselors, a lot of
relationships fall short because of the kids, because of the difference between how a man discipline and a woman discipline, and the kids become the backbone of the relationship and a reason why it don't work no more, because we have these kids. You might be a stepmom to them.
Right.
I don't want you to touch, or I might be a step-pop.
Right.
I'm not allowed to physically discipline your kids.
So my thing is, before we jump that broom, don't we have an understanding where we already been in this relationship for some time to know how,
as to where the kids come?
Yeah, I'm not saying that, but I'm saying we already established our relationship as a couple, so we're going to take this initiative to go to the next level. Then we should already know the common ground, how we're going to discipline these kids, love these kids, provide for these kids. We ain't just going to meet today and we married by next week and we don't know what the hell's going on.
But they come first.
But it's
like you're putting them first over your wife.
What I'm saying is, when we have kids, we automatically do.
That's what I just said. The kids, it's just like we don't even got to, because the kids is just already
right, to put it in more
there.
of a choose the kid or the wife situation, right? To put it more of that, she's having a baby. To save for her to have the baby, she either dies or have the baby. Most dudes would be like, have the baby. She lived her life.
What?
You feel me?
Whoa. What?
Most, no, but that's kind of...
Right? No.
Catholic,
that's real shit.
With Catholic...
So if your wife is pregnant with your baby, and they're like, yo, you got to choose between the baby, having a baby, or your wife living...
Right.
What you doing?
In the Catholic religion,
I'm team FTK.
Have more kids.
Fuck that kid.
We can,
fuck
but in the Catholic religion, they will let you die,
I'm
and your kid is going to be born.
Yeah,
choosing
a wife,
because you can have
shit.
Another child. I don't want to be. Listen. Hear me out on this one.
Okay.
I'm not one for raising a child by myself.
Not
I don't
at all.
Have to.
Right.
So to even though I personally will pick the child over anybody. I love my kids more than anybody. Nobody comes before my kids.
Right.
I don't care what y'all talking about. My kids come first. And any girl in a relationship with me is going to understand that. Mm-hmm. My kids come first.
Right.
Not mean you're going to be ever disrespected.
Yeah.
You're still going to feel loved. You're still going to feel like a queen. But know that my two little queens come first, period.
Right.
If I'm having a baby with somebody,
right,
if they're pregnant, and the doctor say, listen, it's your call. If she has this baby, she's going to die. I'm choosing her to live because I don't want her to die. I don't want to raise a child by myself. I want to give my child a fair chance,
mm-hmm,
which means two parents. Mm.
Here's what's going to fuck you up, though. Like, that's what I always wonder, too. Would the woman make the same choice if it was your life or her unborn child?
No, she wouldn't.
She would
save the kid. She would save the kid.
I can have another baby. I can have another baby.
What if it was your last chance?
Huh?
What if it was your last
then
chance?
We'll adopt that newborn baby somewhere. Whatever. Take an egg from somewhere. But I'm not going to let my husband die.
I don't even know this kid yet.
Oh, you the first woman I ever
with that little dick.
I don't know this kid.
But see, that's I know a lot of women that would break entire relationships up if the man say that they don't want the kids, but the woman do want the kids.
I think it's by case, because if you have women out here who don't have kids at all, like if they never had a child before, they of age and the clock is ticking, they might choose that child because that's all they ever wanted to do was be a mommy, biological mother.
The kids come first.
As opposed to somebody who already got kids. Now, if they already got a child, it's like, all right, I'm going to choose him over the child because I already have one.
That's why two-parent households work best, because the kids come first, right? And when the kids come first, the mom can stay home with the kids. The dad can go bust his ass and bring home the bag so that we can provide for the kids. That's why two households work best.
Yeah, well, that was the original thought when family and creation came about. It was supposed to be two parents.
Yeah.
And we kind of, especially as black people, we kind of got it ass backwards now. We got it kind of fucked up.
I agree.
Because to have, it's almost like an accessory, or it's almost like a privilege to have two parents now, as opposed to being a necessity. That's what it is.
It ain't even normal no more.
We the only race that say shit like, he needs his dad in his life because a woman can't raise a man. Of course the fuck not. Of course not. That should be going without being said.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, this type of shit we always have to say. Y'all got anything else on this topic, though? Like I ain't want to deep us all out.
Not
you know
really,
saying?
Because
like,
we all agreed on that one.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. No, I could definitely agree with that. All right, so let's get a little ratchet for a second. Ladies, let me ask you a question. Do you think that women are qualified to inform a man? What's the better? I'm going to say this a better way.
My God.
you think that you're qualified to let a man know when he's being a man or when he's not being a man due to his actions or his choices?
What do you mean qualified?
Call a man out on his
do you think as a woman, could you tell your man you're not being a man, or you need to do this and be a man, or you need to
man up?
A man up, or a real man would. Or, you know what I mean, shit like that.
So if you're saying if that's my man and he's not standing up to the things that he's supposed to stand up to, then yeah, I'm supposed to let him know.
That's
yeah.
subjective. I'm just talking about
whatever you consider a man is what you
mean. First, I'm not a man, but if I feel like he's not living up to his manly duties, I'm going to speak on it, yes. I can't just say everything that you're supposed to do because I don't know. But if I feel like it's certain things that before we got into this deep, deep, deep relationship that you put out there saying these are the things I'm going to provide for you and this is what I expect of you, Marissa, and I'm living to my situation and you're not, yes, I'm going to speak on it. I think I qualify. That word was kind of qualify. I think I qualify.
The reason why I said qualified is because I think that I think that it's very, very condescending for a woman to tell a man how to be a man.
I can't tell you how to be a man, but if I feel like the bills is getting backed up, babe, and this and that. You telling me you can stay at home and take care of the kids, and I'm taking care of the kids. I'm doing it. I'm washing your clothes. I'm doing the meals, right. Taking care of the necessities that you're telling me to. And I feel like how we backed up in these bills, and I'm out on your back, and you coming and going, and you leaving. How we got to know on the door?
What I'm saying is that if he's a piece of shit, that's different.
Is that telling me I'm not being a man, or I'm just not playing my part in this relationship?
I think it goes both ways. You're not being the man. You're not being the man of your house. You're not being.
So what is the man of the house?
I'd be feeling like you ain't being a man. Why are you husband?
Time out. What'd you say? Star.
It definitely depends on what's being qualified as not being a man.
Right.
Because it's like if a man is gossiping.
Y'all with these
you
fucking
like
drinks,
you acting right. like a girl. Like what's up with you? Like well, why
are you qualified to determine that? Am I qualified to determine whether I'm a man or not?
Yeah.
I'm definitely qualified.
Or is it just hearsay? Because to me, it sounds like hearsay. It sounds like some shit you.
How can it be hearsay in our relationship? It's between you and I.
I'm not myself. Ain't nobody tell me.
Can y'all tell me what men are? Tell me that.
There we go.
First, tell me that.
Start with that. I like that.
Protectors, providers.
That's the base. Like that's the common necessity. The first thing. I say
the man that I want and the man I want. You want me to be submissive. I want you to lead me. So I want my man first to be someone to lead. So yeah. I'm going to follow you by the way you're leading me. As well as you want me to sit back and chill out and be the provider. You want me to sit back and I want to trust you.
Yeah.
I'm not going to sit up here and trust the fact I got you. I got this. And I'm not seeing the God. So yes, I feel like I'm going to step up and be like, babe, what's up here? Do you need me to help you get to where we need to be? Because if you kicked out, nigga, I'm kicked out with these kids.
Yeah.
But does that make me less of a man if you...
Talking to the mic, nigga. You know how to podcast.
No, that don't make you less of a man if you need your woman. I'm supposed to be your rib.
So you're going to let me hold 200 ounces?
Yeah, if you my man.
All right.
I mean, you're holding our $200 technically. It ain't my $200.
I'm
taking it from us.
After I let you hold this $200, is you doing what you need to do so you can never
bring another $800 to bring up another $800.
So listen, here's the funny thing, right? The funny thing is one of the things that Star said a minute ago, she said she was talking about being gossipy. Now we're talking about a character thing as opposed to a responsibility side. See, that's what happens a lot. A lot of times what women do is they take in something that has to do with character or what they consider a character flaw, and then they say, you're not being a man because of this. It's not that you're not protecting and providing. You're just being a bitch-ass nigga right now. So therefore, that's not manly. And that's what I mean by saying condescending. When you say gossipy, I'm like, what does that have to do essentially with being a man? He could just be a loudmouth, chatty-patty-ass nigga. Doesn't make him not a man.
I got mixed reviews about this because I do think a girl can say, but at the same time I don't.
Right.
Because there's rules that men agree with. Like, yo, we can't really be emotional like that. Girls would be like, yo, y'all can be emotional, right? That's what a girl would tell a man to be.
Right.
I want my man to be emotional.
Right. But that's why I'm saying I got mixed reviews. Yeah. Because no man would tell me it's cool to be emotional.
When right. I say emotion, right. I don't need you crying all over the place, but I want you to express your feelings, your thoughts, because I know as a man, I don't know as a man, but with men, y'all hold in a lot of things, and y'all can't sit up here and express a lot of things, because some women be like, you pussy-ass nigga. I'm not right. never going to tell my man he a pussy-ass nigga if he came to me and be like, yo, I'm tired. Like, I got this on my back right now. Yeah. I want to know. Yeah. I want to help you out that, because I'm you, me. We apart. We a union.
Right.
So you can't have you walk around here distressed and depressed.
Even though we're a union and you're backing me up and you hold me down, I don't think a woman is really certified.
They can't.
To
they
tell
not.
A man if he's being a man or not.
See, that's kind of what
I'm
saying.
And here's why. Our minds as men, I don't give a fuck what level you think we're on. We all still got pride. We got self-esteem.
Ego.
Ego. It's something that comes now, along see, with... That comes along with...
That's me. That's us,
you,
though.
But the ego so fucks a lot of things up.
Ego definitely plays a big part. So, it's like, I can tell you how I feel, but try to make... Not, like, disrespect your ego. So, I'm not going to come to you and be like, you acting like a bitch-ass nigga. I would rather come to you like, yo, that wasn't cool. Like, you got... Right. Chill out with that. Like,
Going off of what you just said.
You got to play it right.
All right. Going
probably
off of what you just said.
Then just be like, yo, why you do that? That's
so look. Going off of what you just said, right?
Okay.
Say me and you was in a relationship.
Right.
The way you just supported me and all that type of stuff, right? So here's how you still gonna lose me. Because of my ego. This is why y'all not certified, because you don't understand what we really go through.
Right.
So now look, we out to dinner, cause you asked me, hey look, it's the weekend, we ain't doing nothing. You had a hard week. Let's go out to dinner.
Right.
Damn, I ain't really got the money. I got it. Cool, let's go. We out to dinner, right? Now, most women, this is what y'all do to try to help your man be a man. Y'all gonna pay, but you gonna slide me the money, correct?
You didn't have the money before then.
Y'all gonna pay the bill.
He not
y'all
lying.
Gonna let a nigga, use this car or hit go the money Brody. And pay the bill. So right, he feel right, more right. of a man.
Yeah.
Then you don't know how to make a man feel like a man. If you pay the bill, I feel like a bitch. We go out to eat, you pull your wallet out, and you paying. I owe you some ass because I had lobster and steak. I'm a man. I'm supposed to pay. That's my job.
What?
No, we're not going to do that.
See, this is why you can't tell men how to be men.
Right.
You straight up tell men. You just straight up told a guy he don't got to pay for dates.
Because
every girl here said the basics is provided and protection.
Right.
So you just said the basics is out the window when it comes to your man.
You can't. I never said you can't. I'm saying this is how y'all lose it. Because of our ego,
right.
Because I didn't have the money to actually take you the fuck out, you're paying a bill.
No, now but here's my thing. This is just me, how I am, as a woman and as a friend. Right. If you don't have it, and I say I'm treating, I'm giving you the money beforehand, because nobody else need to know you don't got it.
Facts.
You could be my best friend, or you could be my man. But nobody need to know you didn't have it. If Marissa called me, we going out. She like, Marissa, we out. Well, Star, I really don't got it. I don't want people to know I'm paying for her. That's not their business.
Right.
Here, Marissa, we outside. What? In the car, once we get inside, they don't know you don't got it because you got it.
See,
I agree with that.
At the end of the day, you don't even got to do all that. If we out and I say, babe, we going out and I got it, I'm pulling my card out. You ain't got to feel no less than a man. That's my boo.
When the last time you did that? What, Mike?
No, but if I take you on a date, I'm paying.
I don't have to feel less of a man.
Yeah.
I'm telling you, that makes me feel.
I'm treating you out, babe. We going out. So you feel less of a man because I'm treating you.
When the last time you did that?
One at a time.
To understand a man, you got to listen to a man.
I'm treating you out.
All right, that's how simple you're making it. I'm not making it simple. You're pulling out your checkbook, paying for me.
When the last time When the last time y'all did that? Pulled your card out, took a nigga.
Like 2 weeks ago, it was September. Take a man on a date month, and if I'm taking you,
hold the fuck up! I missed that whole month. What? Who did what?
Wait a minute. Hold up. Wait a minute.
I got treated.
I'm glad she said that. It was take a man on a date month. It don't gotta be a take a bitch on a date month for us to pay for the date.
It was obligation.
No. What I'm saying is, you asked me the last time I did it. You didn't say is that all I do. If I'm taking you on a date, I'm paying, no matter what the money is. But if I want to go on a date and you can't afford it and you my man,
nobody needs to know you can't afford it.
All right, look, I got a better question.
If I call you like,
all right, no, as a man.
Okay, that's your ego fucking with you.
I'm talking about as a real fucking man.
That's your ego.
Wait, one more time. Hey, B, before you go with your question.
That's your ego fucking with you. Is no reason. If your woman want to take you out, all right, she can take you out. All right,
listen. Hold on.
I don't agree.
Let me ask y'all.
Ain't nobody saying I'm about to front the whole house, the crib, the mortgage, the cars outside.
Let me say.
No, we going to Red Lobster.
I don't agree.
I got a synopsis, right?
I got something
I think about in this whole situation. The reason why y'all go back and forth is because women weaponize empathy. And what happens is that when you weaponize empathy, a man is always on guard for that. Do you understand what I mean by weaponizing empathy? What I mean is that you'll ride for that situation and understand and let him know, like, look, babe, don't worry about it. Slide you the card. You act like you paying because nobody else need to know. But the first time that nigga step out of line and y'all get into an argument,
you broke ass nigga.
You couldn't even pay when we went to dinner that time.
You the king of the house.
You can't even pay for burger.
I'm not even in the relationship. How many times y'all went on a first date and pulled y'all car?
Like, y'all talking heavy.
No, we're not doing the first date. That's my point.
That's the whole point. Make sure you're in the camera shot.
He didn't say the first date because at the end of the day, if you asking me to go out and you can't afford it, then why would you be asking me on the first date? Get yourself together and then we can go on a date.
Hold on. So that's back to Will's point.
They got 2 for 20.
Why would he be going on a date if he can't afford it, period? So if he can't afford it, period,
but you my man, baby. You're my man.
Okay, so, but a first date. You going on a date with this is a dude that you potentially see as your
potential.
Nifty 50s is like you get
we ain't
nifty,
got no crib.
Nifty 50s is like $40.
You paid for the date. All right, wait. You paid for the date, right? All right, cool. Let's add this to the scenario. I'm your man.
Yes.
You make more money than me. I'm supposed to be cool with that, right? You my girl. I'm supposed to be cool with you making more money than me.
It had happened before. Yeah.
You had a dude that was cool with you.
I was in a relationship. I did make more money than him. I had a job and I was
bartending. Are y'all still in that relationship?
No, that's not the reason we're not together no more.
Yeah, I'm telling you, that's part of it.
That's definitely
no
part of it.
In the world, it's going to be okay
did you
with
feel,
this woman why can oh, I just, more money
no.
than him.
No.
Look,
no.
Okay. I'm going to be honest. Can I be honest? Hold up. Can I be honest here?
That means you're running a relationship.
I'm going to be honest right now.
Go ahead.
With her. She was on a podcast a couple weeks ago.
Yes.
I see her on Instagram. Yeah. You not the type of chick that's gonna respect a man that don't make more money than
me?
You.
You saying me?
Yes.
Wait, how? Because you're being judgmental off my Instagram. You don't know what I did. I'm not even in a relationship with somebody.
No. I'm saying even your conversation on the last podcast, girls like you don't respect. You want a guy on your level or above, correct?
I want him to be on my level.
Right. So the niggas below you, he gets no respect.
No. I'm not gonna disrespect the niggas because he's below me. Don't you dare
you
sound like that motherfucking siren.
You ain't even deal with him.
I'm about to be 38 years old. We not about to step into a relationship and you not. I got three kids, one in college. So at this, I know what I want. I done had sex. I done had kids. I done been evicted. I done went through some shit. So I'm not trying to go backwards into some shit that you ain't been through with me. So I need you to be on my level or above me. It has nothing to do with his bank book rolling, but at least come to me equally or at least a little bit more. So if you say you got 800, all right, so I got 800 too. Can we carry it together? Yeah. I'm not trying to be better than you. I'm trying to be equally yoked with somebody. I ain't got time to be, because I'm bad bitch energy. I'm fucking grown.
But a problem with it is
not
what,
equally
the,
yoked.
Right, because
equally yoked.
When somebody is equally. Listen, no, Marissa, when somebody is equal in a relationship with you, you know what happens, especially with women and whatnot. You still look at him as the provider. The problem with it is if y'all are equally yoked, he's yoking more than you are. So therefore, you keep your egg. His shell stays empty. That's
zip
the whole point.
I can't hear you.
So you gotta
zip me up.
So you gotta find a way in order for that to work out. Like, you're always gonna want him to get out there and get to it, even if he. But the problem is, his money is your money, and your money is your money, and that's how it's always
going to
be.
But listen, it's not gonna say that it's not. But I've also was in a relationship where we had a joint relationship. A joint account. I was.
How'd that work out?
That shit don't.
It was me fucking it up.
Oh my god.
That weak ass account. My main account was popping. You want a joint account?
I was messing it up. I'm honest though.
I put a little $400 or $500 in that account. I'm not fucking.
And that's why I say the way you talk. Do you hear yourself?
talking.
Sir.
And then when I say you not going to respect the nigga that make more money than
First
you, look
all,
at
I'm
me crazy.
I'm not a disrespectful person, so I ain't going to disrespect them. But at the end of the day, just take care of what you got to take care of. That's all.
Did you ever call a nigga? Did you call him a brokey? Did you come at his neck? You ever come at his neck? I'm asking
you. I'm going to say yes.
I'm
going to say yes, but I never call him no broke ass nigga.
What you say to him?
I talk shit. Like, talk fuck out of here. I was there for you when you ain't had nothing, nigga. And now you getting your shit together, nigga.
You ain't had shit.
I didn't say
everything I just said about her. Everything I just said that I think this girl is, she just said it. Word for word.
Listen.
I don't respect no nigga that make less money than me. You just said it.
What happened?
Because that's what you just did it. You just did it. You weaponized your empathy.
Okay,
you empathize with the nigga
mad,
and then when it didn't fit
mad,
your suit,
and that's,
you turn that shit into nunchucks, started whipping the shit out of that nigga.
And that's why I said last week, boss bitches don't want to be boss bitches because when it's time to boss up, they complain. So when it was
time
for you to boss up, you told that bitch ass nigga, get your weight up. You need to get more money.
No, all right, so
I never told him that. I never told him.
Say it was broke.
Yo, y'all girls just don't be hearing yourselves.
I said, nigga, when you was down, I ain't say you was broke. I said, when you was down, nigga, I was with you.
That's the same.
Don't shine on me.
You said you ain't that
shit, nigga.
Hold
up. Get up.
If when I say I was down, that mean I was broke. Then anytime you hear a nigga say I was down, that mean I was broke.
The synonym game.
Up means I got money now. Down means I was down.
Well, listen, I was there when we was wearing Reeboks, and now we wearing Balenciaga. Okay,
shit.
So don't show
when
off on me when
broke,
you get there.
When
I was wearing the motherfucking Reeds with you.
First
don't show off when we wearing the Balenci's. Okay.
First and foremost. Y'all shouldn't be talking about each other no type of way if y'all wearing Balenciagas and shit.
Girl, it's crazy, man.
Y'all still talk about each other.
No, you need to downgrade then. Go take your ass back to fucking Nike, you know what I'm saying, and Puma, everybody else.
We were so happy for him, but we got rich.
You can straight lead this to the next topic. Who sacrifices more? Because after all that,
you might as well. I did have like an in-between topic, like a 0.5 topic, right? Are women fighting for equality?
No.
Say it again.
Are women fighting for equality? Do women want
to
be equal?
Equal as far as what?
All right, here we go. That's
no.
I got two. I've been saying this for a couple weeks now. I have two different words that mean essentially kind of the same thing, but they have two different meanings. They have two meanings when you dig into it. Equality is what women say they want. This is the definition of equality. A state of being equally. A state of being equal, especially in status, rights, and opportunities. That's equality, okay? This is equity, because this is what I feel like women want.
Mm-hmm.
The quality of being fair and impartial.
Yes. Basically, y'all want to be special.
And treatment-wise. So that's what
it is. Break it down,
basically,
bro.
Y'all
want
to be special.
Women don't want equality. Y'all want equity.
Right.
Equity means y'all looked at in the same light. But if I ask you to lift that, if we got to go pick a car up outside, ain't no one to follow when to go
through
that
shit. I'm not putting out the
trash. Wait, so are you saying in your relationship, or are you just saying in the whole?
I'm talking about the whole world. Well, it happens in a relationship, too.
I don't want to be equal to a man. A man's supposed to be a man, a woman's supposed to be a woman.
Agreed.
I don't want to be equal to you. I said that earlier as a point of me trying to be submissive. Let me be submissive and soft for you.
So you don't mind playing a traditional role. So
no, I don't. But I want that man.
So when men are speaking, you don't talk until you. Until
I'm
you
talking
ask
right
to.
Now because right I ain't meet my person.
But that's what I'm saying. If your person would ask you that, you don't speak. You don't. When you don't
I'm,
walk
I'm,
in a room
I'm,
and start
I'm,
and
gradually
insert yourself
learning
in conversation.
To be that way. I pray to be that
She's
way.
She's not that way.
You're not that
no, way. No, I'm not. I said
You're
I'm
not going to sugarcoat it. She's not that way.
Excuse me.
What you think will make her that way?
I said I'm praying. He can't make me that way.
Do you
like Tom and Jerry?
Listen to her.
What do y'all think? What do you think would make you that way, Marissa?
Okay, so I want a man.
Talking to the mic.
I want a man that's a man. And when I say a man, yes, I want you to be able to speak. And when you speak, I don't want to speak. I want to know that you carrying it and you taking care of it. When you say, Marissa, chill, I got it. I want to chill. I don't want to go toe to toe with you. This is a podcast. I don't want to do this with you
right.
in my relationship.
Right,
no,
right,
I don't
right.
want to get all hot and heavy and all
but
that.
But what
no.
keeps you from doing that?
a man with understanding.
Come on, Marissa.
A man
stop.
With understanding.
Stop.
A man that understands that with us as women, we have. But a lot of men are. I got a disagreement with a man today. I told him, I said, you know, a lot of men today are battling a lot of things from their childhood that they bring into their adulthood. He got mad. That's a fucking lie. In their 20s and their 30s, they go through.
Right, that's fact.
But
that's
I said,
fact.
I'm not saying every man. It's no. Some men. I meet a lot of guys that I've not
that's
even
a human
dated.
Being.
They come, they bring their things
that's,
into.
That's human beings.
Yeah. Yes, that's true. What I'm saying is, a lot of men don't have a safe place. A lot of
we
men don't. Women
we
do.
Don't.
Especially with women.
Women do.
But can I say
men
something?
Men don't have a safe place.
Especially with y'all.
But can I say something? When we do have a safe place and we start speaking our mind and this, that, and the third, y'all shit on it.
Stop being a bitch.
Stop.
I never told a man not
to
be a bitch.
All these men be doing podcasts and talking shit. Ooh. That's our safe place.
That's crazy.
That's our safe place. Now we get a safe place and we start to, it's not just the barbershop. It's just not the locker room. We're on podcast telling y'all how we really feel now. And y'all don't like that shit.
They hate it. They hate
y'all
it.
Hate
here's
it.
My thing. In my opinion, I think that women really want the equity. They want to be paid the same. They want to be able to apply for the same jobs. They want to be able to play sports. They want to be able to do that. But at the same
time,
but
you don't want to do the same
they
work.
Don't want to take out the trash.
Of course not.
I'm not changing my oil.
No.
I'm not fixing no tires. I'm not doing none of that.
Can I say something about men having a safe place?
And to men, it got to be about you being single or in a relationship.
Right.
Because if I'm single, then now I want equal equity. I want both.
But you want
but
equity.
But if I'm in a relationship, I don't need to be equal to you, bro, because I'm not putting out that trash. I'm not picking up no dead mice. I'm not doing it.
I understood. All right, so say if you single and you want, you single, you don't need no man, but you want that equity.
One woman don't
so,
want no man.
So here, no, I'm just saying that you don't
he
need
a man. He said need,
no,
not
let's
want.
Just say you don't need, but
no,
whatever.
I want a man.
You don't
I
have
need
one.
A man.
You ain't in search right now. So, but you still want that equity. But you want to treat it like equality. So what makes, what? How do you deserve to make as much as the man does? How do you deserve to drive the car the man drives? If you don't want to take care of it, if you don't want to do these things in order to upkeep your life and your lifestyle, how do you deserve to do that?
Because some of the jobs that y'all do, we definitely can do and do it better.
But
like
y'all don't do
dummies.
It. But y'all
don't
do it.
Don't do it.
At the end of the day, if it comes to
come on,
you
come
saying, on, all right, I don't want to take out the trash, but I'm also not applying to be a damn trash woman.
Agreed. So
that's the thing. I'm not doing it because that's not what I want to do. So I don't want to be paid equal as you as a trash woman.
Trash woman
because
for the
I don't want to do it.
Trash woman for the city
makes six
figures.
Can I say something
real
quick? It's equal pay. The thing is, it's equal pay. All that's been debunked since the 90s, right? The difference is y'all take the less paying jobs. So when the statistics come out, they go full time women versus full time men. They don't take account of what jobs we're doing. So they just go full-time men versus full-time women. Right. Y'all making less money, right? That's because the predominantly high-paying jobs are men, right? So y'all taking the low-paying jobs. So now when we do the statistics on who's making more money, y'all like, y'all get paid 80 cents to the dollar when y'all are fucking teachers and we're fucking in STEM.
No. So I feel like, is this mic on? Can y'all hear me?
Absolutely.
Okay, thank you.
Absolutely.
I feel like when it comes to men and women, it will never be equally because I'm going to go into birth. Us women, we give birth. We do this, we do that, and we got to go back and work and act like ain't nothing. So a man should take care of a woman, period. That's how I feel.
And I agree.
It will never be equal. Like, it can never be, she make more, if my man making this, I need to cut because I'm carrying these babies. I'm making sure this house clean. I'm making sure you good because if I'm good, you good. You can't walk out of here without being good. We going to be good if I make, I got to be happy.
Can
if
I agree with
happy,
you? Can I agree with you?
Sure.
I agree with you.
All right, thank you. I'm done.
But now I got it. Hold on. You might not want to leave just so far.
Yeah, don't leave so fast.
You might not want to leave too fast because
it's always a toxic trail behind with something that people say. There's always something toxic you can follow it up.
Having a baby is an option.
Oh, shit.
So what if you are like, fuck it, I don't want to have kids. I'm going to focus on my career. Right? What if you don't want to have kids? What I'm saying is having a kid is an option.
Right.
It is.
So you saying we carry the babies out of
an option that we
don't have an option.
Right.
Y'all have an option to choose that.
Let me ask y'all a question real quick. Who's the giver of life?
Men.
Women.
Men are the giver of life.
Y'all the harbors of life.
Y'all the harbors,
but we... Y'all the harbors of life.
Y'all do exactly what God created women to do, and that is support man in life.
Yes. Right.
So therefore, when women say we the givers of life, yes, you carry what y'all we carry give to life. You, what we create.
So what?
We create and we gave it to you.
Wait. Let me tell
y'all
why. Let me tell you why men are the...
Stop shooting the club, but
let me tell you why men are the creators. Wait. Let me tell you why men are the creators of life. We create more life. You can get pregnant. You're done for 9 months. I could get you and pregnant, her pregnant, and her pregnant tonight.
All right, Nick Cannon, chill out.
No, but that's why I'm not saying I would do that.
Right, but what I'm saying is
we have the option to.
Right.
That's why we are the creators of life.
And after 9 months, I did have a baby with Craig, and then another 9 months, Nick Cannon, and then him over here looking all sad.
Right. But you gotta wait 9 months.
Yeah, but you gotta wait.
I can get you pregnant. You tell me you're pregnant. I can come back to the bar, get another bitch pregnant. You have to wait 9 months.
Yeah. Okay.
You feel me? Nick Cannon procreates more than any chick on this world.
Talk to the mic.
We gotta hear you. Okay. Let me go.
It goes back to when he said, why do you feel like men and women, like why women should be treated equally, even though men do more work? So you say.
Yeah.
But y'all talking about just working, like women have these babies and it's a lot to come after these babies. You got postpartum, your body changed, your mind changed, everything. And y'all forgetting that. Y'all just thinking, oh, bitches just popping out babies. No, we don't forget that.
That's
really an option. These babies do stuff to women.
We go through a lot of the same shit. Yo, we absolutely do.
Have a great day. Absolutely.
Hold on.
Talk about your symptoms. I want to know. I've never.
We get all that shit too.
Yeah, we get all of it.
And we got to deal with you.
Yeah, we got to deal with your sad ass. That's great.
Not the sad ass.
Knock in the morning to go get
at the end of the day, you're a man.
We was talking about fucking ice cream. We was having fun. We was humping. Now I'm pregnant with the fucking nose. Wait, hold up. When you was humping, you was having a good time. Hold up. I still gotta go back to having a baby is the fucking option.
Because if you got pregnant and you didn't want to have the baby, you can say, fuck, I'm not ready to have a baby. Get rid of it.
Right.
So having a baby is a fucking option. So if you don't want to deal with the bullshit that comes with having a baby, get rid of that motherfucker.
Having a baby for these women is
so
a
So you
come
an abortion nigga. That's why you're not kids.
I never had an abortion in my life.
Every nigga is an abortion nigga.
Can you say
nigga.
That?
Every nigga is an abortion. Every nigga is
no,
an abortion.
No, I cannot.
Exactly.
So don't talk about being.
First of all, I ain't talking about no motherfucking
You abortion
baby.
John. No, you an abortion John. You like that? You ain't like when you said it about me. You don't like what I said about you.
I would have an abortion with you. Ain't no problem. Go ahead.
What I'm saying is I never had an abortion. So for you to be like,
you
an abortion nigga.
Because you ain't got no vagina.
I'm so immature.
I never paid for a girl to get an abortion. No girl I had sex with.
So you a condom nigga all the time, every day, all day.
I never got a bitch.
Or you just don't got no sperm count.
Oh, my God.
Even after a woman gets an abortion, her body still go through her still being pregnant. Just so you know, even if you get a girl pregnant and she say I'm getting an abortion, she's still going to go through postpartum. She's still, her body's still, y'all just, we just pregnant. We just finished trying to collect $300. She ain't even pregnant. Y'all don't even be pregnant. Y'all be lying. We don't. That bitch ain't even pregnant. Give me $300. The way these girls talking, I don't even know if that's my baby.
Yo.
They ain't even pregnant.
Hold up.
You can't have sex for 6 weeks after abortion. It's the same thing. We just prematurely snatched the baby from the womb.
Hold up. Carry on. Hey, Will. They called B abortion man. All I can think is this nigga walking around with a cape with a big ass A on the back. Nigga, abortion man, that's crazy.
Abortion nigga.
Meanwhile, I had none. Did I ask her, have you had an abortion?
Yeah.
Way to shit on somebody when you dated too.
Brandon ain't shitting on me. I curved that. I had a
baby. Your sperm don't work though. No way. You never had no girl pregnant ever.
I never said I never got an abortion.
She told him. She just ain't telling.
You never got an abortion.
So y'all want to go there? I had a miscarriage before. Bitch had a miscarriage.
You carried that baby. You miscarried.
She had a miscarriage.
Yo, abortion
is
crazy.
My fucking child.
We go through the same shit.
We go through the same shit.
Stop.
We go through the same
shit. Hold up.
He stressed her ass out so bad Gina lost the baby. You stressed
her. That's fucked up.
He stressed her out that's so bad up, she miscarried.
Hi, see, that's what I mean. Now, wait a whole goddamn minute. Wait a minute, because I got to stick up for my bro. What we not going to do, no, your mic is cut. What we doing right now is you not going to come at my man and say he stressed the bitch out so bad that she lost the baby.
Oh, that's
because, wait a minute, though, because if a nigga say that to a chick, y'all would have crucified, y'all would have set that nigga on fire right in that seat.
Wait, can I get
Let's go toxic.
Go toxic.
Let's go toxic. Three, where your baby dad's at?
Around.
Exactly.
Around.
Are you single?
No, I'm not.
Stop playing.
I am. Hold on.
Thank
we're
you.
Go there.
You are.
We single. So what you we for? Single Thank by you. Choice over here.
No,
you single
not.
Why?
No, you're not. No
you single why?
You was embarrassed to say it, though.
Hold up.
I'm
single with
you
no baby moms. My baby and mom. Hold up.
You stressed her out. She killed the baby to die.
My baby mom will be stressed out. My baby died. Let me kill her. My baby mom will not be single. You are. Sorry.
You didn't kill me. How did you kill me?
You wow. got three kids and you're still single.
All right, we got to move
trash.
On to it. Move on. Whoa.
That's trash.
No.
Let me three carry kids him. Let me single. Carry him. Let me carry him.
Trash.
Let me carry him. Let me carry him. Let me carry him.
37
is still out here. Trash talking, but can't keep one. It don't matter what you got going on. Because
you 37 and can't keep one.
Baby.
38. 10 years older than me and can't keep one.
Black, we please listen. We doing content and whatnot. It's all love. Take a deep breath. Smoke your hookah. Drink your drink.
All right, listen up.
Go ahead.
All right. So in the midst of y'all conversation. Something was said that's real important in our community that for some reason, for one, I disagree with it. B said by the time he's 38, he's going to be married. Now, in our community, for some reason, status. So in our community, we look at marriage like that's the number one status. If we're married,
right.
We're better than.
No,
we're
I'm
higher
that's
than.
My
no,
goal.
No, no, no. No. Because all the time. This is why women spend every dollar they got going debt and all that on a wedding. The wedding is for one fucking day.
It's for one
they
day.
They blow the whole savings to look good for one day
one
in
day.
Front of a bunch of people they want to show off in front of to impress. No. It's instilled in y'all since birth. No. Y'all be playing with doll babies, little kids, and Y'all marriage is the number one goal, but no. Why is that? Why is that so important? Because there's a lot of unhappy married people.
Yep.
Y'all rushing to get married, don't know why y'all getting married. It's not being done out of love no more. It's
Most
being done out of stability.
Are
right.
Right.
That's it. Exactly.
The husband.
But wait a minute. See, this is the thing.
That's what I'm saying.
Wait, let me ask y'all a question though, Star. How do y'all understand you all three of y'all agree, all four of y'all agree? But all four of y'all want to get married.
No. Star's already married, 11 years.
Mel doesn't want to get married.
Right. You don't want to get married.
Mel's 34.
Like I said.
No kids.
No kids.
Great
no
job.
No marriage. No marriage.
Right. My own.
No, don't, you don't want to get
no
married.
No marriage. No. I would take a man.
If it presents itself, she will.
If it presents itself.
I promise
with
you.
With the right man. But the way these men are nowadays, I don't see it happening.
All right, but that's not what I'm asking. See, that's kind of.
I feel like
a woman wants to get married. I'm not going
to
get married just for the glitz and the glamour.
Right,
but
right,
of course,
right.
I'm going to have a beautiful wedding.
But why do you want to get married?
I want to get married because
she's
I want to be with that person, and that's who
you
all
can
I want to
be
with. Still
be with that person.
But are you telling me not to have a wedding?
No. This is what I'm saying. I'm saying y'all put so much
because that's a woman
a
like that's
significant more than a relationship itself.
Because you can have a banging ass relationship for the rest of your life and never get married and be happy with that person.
Okay, so you feel like when a person get married, that's when things go down.
Hell yeah.
Not all the time.
You're tripping.
I don't agree with that. I mean, it's your opinion, but not all the time. I'm really the only one
that can speak on that. I've been married for 16 years.
I've been married for 37 years.
20 years.
And they had an extravagant wedding. They still together. Four children.
Listen. And here's why.
I think today in our time, we're living in yes.
No. Here's why. This is a proven fact. Proven fact. We just kicking it. Me and you, we just got together. We fucking around. We busted up. We having sex. It's cool. We agree that we're not in a relationship, right? Mm-hmm. You're not going through my phone. You're not calling me. Like, where you at right now? We just kicking it. We're at the first stage. Nobody bugging out. Nobody toxic right now, right? We're in the beginning. This is how it goes.
You said nobody bugging out, nobody toxic
it's
right
level.
Now.
Listen, fuck. It's level. It's level. Then you always going to be single. No, not you always
single. Exactly.
Your toxic is no choice.
You girls is fucking horrible.
You're toxic.
And niggas really don't get that.
Hold on, one mic.
So let me finish.
Right. Let me ask you a question.
Wait. Let me finish and let it come to me.
Hold on. In the beginning.
That's not true.
It is. Because if I want to be in a late shot, just go grab an ugly joint. Whatever.
Right.
We're single by choice.
Everybody is. Right. But nobody has good options.
Back to what I said.
Oh, my God.
In the beginning.
Oh, my God, yo.
You have an option to be in a relationship. You have an option to be fucking single. Why is it so hard for people to comprehend that?
Wait, no.
Can I break it down?
It's an option.
Please break it down.
I'll follow up.
No. Listen. B is single. I am not single by choice. Right? I could go get... There's plenty of girls that... Hold up, look. There's plenty of girls that want to be my girl. Right?
It's a choice.
Hold up. But they can't. Right? If they could fit the bill, I wouldn't be single. I would be taken.
It's a choice, babe. It's a choice.
Hold up. Stop cutting me off for 1 second. Y'all stop cutting me off. I'm agreeing with you. We all have the choice to go get somebody, right? But what the thing is, they don't fit our options. They don't fit our preference. So they're not a good choice, right? We could all go work at Walmart. Why not? It's a choice to go work there. You don't want to work there, though. We don't want these bum-ass jobs, right? You don't want no bum-ass job, so you wouldn't work at no bum-ass job. Yeah, there's a lot of bum-ass bitches that want to be with me. They can't. So I'm not single by choice, because if I had some good options, I wouldn't be fucking single.
But sometimes you're looking at the wrong options.
This girl just don't get it.
This is the thing, right? You can have all of these women in your face. Sometimes it be the wrong options. It's the atmosphere of the fuck we live in sometimes. And you can say that, well, you're not married, you got three kids. That don't bother me at all. Sometimes it's the atmosphere you in, the scenery around, the motherfucking niggas and the bitches that's around. So you can't say that. Because at the end of the day, you can be a good-ass corporate motherfucking working, three bars, six cars outside, and you still meeting the wrong motherfucker. That's the option that you don't want in your fucking life.
But that's why you be single.
But you also got to weigh your options with your goals.
See, that's the problem. Right. That's the problem, though. What you're saying is, it negates what you say. You say, yes, you are single by choice, but you don't have the option to get married. Even if you're not single, that's a fact.
But this is also my thing. I'm also that wasn't the question.
But your goal is to get married, right? But listen,
another reason why I am single is because I have shit within myself that I'm trying to work on.
Absolutely.
And that's one of my biggest things.
That's a great thing.
And a lot of people can't handle my mental. And I'm not settling for a man that I'm in this toxic shit because I'm a little fucked up, and some people can't handle that. A lot of people don't want to take the time out because it's, oh, bitch, that's your issue.
No, like, I get that.
You understand? Yeah, so fix. I ain't mean a man that have the come patience. Fix. Like,
so,
that
so, so let me ask you a question. Enough. Let me ask you a question.
I agree. Come fix.
That's right, what I'm saying.
Right, but no. But when you come out the other side.
Everybody should come fix. The male and the female.
When you come out of the other side of that, do you think that it's easy for you to get married if you come out the other side of that?
I'm not sure.
This is the thing, because I always say this, and this is something. I want to get married.
Women fuck who they want. Men fuck who they can. Men fuck who they can. And I mean, I'm sorry. Men marry who they want, and women marry who they can. Point blank, period.
Cause
and
look,
it happens. That's the name of it. Especially as you get older, and it sucks.
I feel
but
like
that's
when
how
you're
it
older,
works.
It's probably more pressure because people. No, it's not pressure. You should be married. No, because you see, a lot of people do get married because they're like, I need to be married by this certain age. It's pressure. You know what I'm saying?
What's the age?
The timing. Listen, this man just said he's going to be married by 38.
Why do you need to be married is my question.
I'm saying that's a goal of mine.
To be married. Right, right.
I'm saying I
said
one
day. To be married. What I said was, he said when you
I
get
said
older,
one day
women
I
want to
be married.
Want to get right. married. I said, that's true because it's pressures behind it. You at a certain age, you're 34, you don't got no kids. Listen, I'm 34 with no kids.
What
people
you talking
think
about?
It's some. You got some people that be like, well, what's wrong with you? Then you got some yeah. people like, you know what? She did it right. You understand what I'm saying? So it's shit. Like, it depends on who you surround yourself with.
I'm definitely one like, what's wrong with you?
No, no, me, I'm like, I'm team FTK.
The bitch ain't want to settle.
I'm team fuck them kids. I'm team fuck them kids. I got a grown son in college. I got a daughter that's a teenager.
I'm on that team too.
But they grown,
yes,
almost grown, so I can still
as
be fucking
talk,
kids.
As long as you take care of them, you definitely could be like, fuck them kids.
That's my nigga. But that's what I'm saying. But it's still team fuck them kids, though.
Fuck them kids. I'm going to say it's
I ain't having no more. Let's move on to the next topic, man. Did you want to do the joint that you were talking about, or is that a little bit too much?
The
topic we were talking about with the who sacrifices more? Let's do it. Who sacrifices more in a good relationship, men or women?
Women.
Sacrifice more. I want to hear that.
Yeah,
because
tell us.
Here's my thing. Earlier you were saying a man can't tell you, a woman can't tell you this, and a woman can't do this, and da 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 da. So we gotta sacrifice our beliefs. We gotta sacrifice. If I can't, your ego. We gotta sacrifice way too much.
Why you say ego like that?
Because I can't even talk to you in a proper way because I'm not qualified to. Fuck with your ego.
You're gonna tell me how to be a man. It's a difference. Right. And I can't tell you how to be a woman.
All right,
but you will.
No, who I'm sacrifices like more?
In a woman, that's a difference.
You, dog.
Yeah, listen, I got a question.
I can't tell you how to be a man.
I think a man sacrifices.
Remember, this is a good relationship. So
A good relationship. So my question is,
to me, in a good relationship is equal.
Hold up. Do y'all believe in?
Never.
Hold up. Do y'all believe in happy wife, happy life?
No.
Happy spouse,
no,
happy
no,
house.
No,
happy
no, house. Hold up.
Happy spouse, happy house.
Let them answer. They the girls. Let them answer.
Right. Yeah.
I said it before him. Happy spouse, happy house.
Okay.
That's it. That's another one of the weaponizing.
Happy
shit.
Wife, happy life.
Yeah, you're making me happy. I'm making work.
That right, because we're sacrificing our happiness to make you happy.
But she said who sacrificed the
more.
Yes.
Yes. Who, I feel like women do.
Why? Why do you feel women do?
I say that to say a lot of women, we trying to be something that you want us to be. So that, again, plays into the part that if you want us to be more laid back, I don't want you going out that much. Okay, I'm not going to go out that much. I'm being submissive. I'm not going to do this. I cook more. I'm cleaning more. I'm trying to be all that you want me to be for you. So I'm sacrificing certain things to be that woman you want me to be.
Do you realize that men conform to everything in relationships? There is nothing that a man comes into with any expectation of a woman. He just wants you to look a
That's
certain way.
That's not true. Because I've been meeting a lot of men that just be really wanting you to be all these extra. You're checking off. Okay, I don't like the bathing suit picture. Take it down.
Right,
I want
look,
you to relax. Don't
I
say
said,
this.
I said look a certain way. Look and present a certain way. With men, the nigga got to have his shit together. He got to have the money right. He got to have the ambition. He got to want a certain amount of kids. He got to not live with his mama. He got to have a certain type of
Every
car.
Every man should do Every, that
He
got to
treat
regardless.
You a certain way.
That's something that you should want to do for
the basic.
Yourself
but what
as
I'm
a
saying
man.
Is, but that's the expectation. What I'm saying is that it's always going to be expected. The reason why that it's more on the man is because no matter what,
so y'all sacrifice more than us, basically.
Let me answer why. I think men sacrifice
Listen
the
to
most
you over here
because,
on the sidelines.
Because look what y'all asks to bring to the table. Y'all asks right. to bring protection and provide. That means I gotta put my life on the line for you. If somebody breaks in our house, you want me to go down there and go check that shit out, right? Yep. That's sacrificing my life.
We
for
calling
you.
The cops together.
Oh, wait.
Cause she know her man a
bitch. Hold up. So, hold up.
Big.
So, right. So that's what I'm saying. Y'all want the dude to protect you. If somebody's out in public and somebody threatens you, you want your man to step up and do that. Put his life on the line for you. Yeah, his life is on the line for his girl. Right. For one, that's a big sacrifice, a life. Okay. Not only that, I agree.
Protect and provide.
Hold up. Yep. My finances, my money. Because once I get married, this our money, right? My money's our money, your money's your money, right? So I'm sacrificing my money, too. So, yeah, man, I could be selfish and be like, I got a bag. Take care of yourself. Live over there. Buy your own crib. I just want to, you mean? But I want to take care of you, right? You want a leader. Hold up. Women want leaders. Y'all want a nigga who can lead. So we're talking about a happy relationship. He's a leader. You follow. So we talking about... A dude is in charge, like the dude that you want. Like, I'm not saying these the regular deck. Most dudes that a girl would get in a relationship with is on her level or above, right? He's stronger. He's like everything is better.
Let me ask you a question.
Let
me ask you a question, Marissa. What does the man that you're with require of you on a regular basis? What?
Get him from right here, y'all. I'm gonna punch his ass out this fucking chair on his light skin shit.
You heard what I said. What does the person that you're with on a regular basis require of you?
All right, so the person that I'm currently seeing, he wants me to be a woman that's again. Shut your ass up. And one day, he want me to chill back. Be quiet. Let him lead.
Right.
He wants me...
I said right. I'm agreeing with you.
I don't even want all, you to agree with me.
But that's all situational.
He's saying, basically, I'm toxic.
You just want to argue with me.
I don't want him to agree with me. Crazy. I want y'all to agree with me.
So,
see, the teleport is kicking in now, so I'm somewhere else. He wants me to make a motherfucking sandwich. He wants me to be submissive and shut the fuck up. He says to me, I need you to let the man lead and let the man just provide, Marissa. You don't need to always have something to say. You don't always have to be the one that want to be on the front line.
So what are you sacrificing?
Does it require that of you?
Shut the fuck up.
Does it require, he requires that of you?
That's a lot.
That's a deal breaker.
That's a lot. It's a lot for a woman that comes from a line of women that's always been strong. I had to carry it by myself. I see my mom carry it by herself. So I see my mom married
now.
But
you got a man who want to be in your life right now, so you don't have to carry it by yourself. But you still stuck in your ways where you have to treat him like the way you see your mom treat
other people.
No, break generational curses because you're not going to come
into this place. I'm agreeing.
That extra
shit. Shut the fuck
up. You don't got to spit on the mic. Don't spit on the mic. I agree. Come save me, nigga.
I want you to agree with me.
No. Say what women say. I want you to want to agree with me. That's something women would say.
I just said that before I got cut off. I said that I'm seeing my mother. I came from a generation of women that been strong, had to carry me
that
back.
That shit is the easiest shit in the world to share when you got a good man. It's the easiest shit in the world to get rid of.
So the person that taught me, I learned her toxic ways of being single, independent, doing it on my own. Now I'm seeing her marry her. She's submissive to her husband. I'm like, Mom, you ain't gonna say nothing? I'm watching that. So now that makes me
You know why? Because she wanna keep that nigga. That's why. She wanna keep his ass.
I'm like, Mom, he said that. You ain't say nothing? I would never tell my mom to say nothing.
My shit ended.
Thank God. But anyway,
But see, that's what I'm saying.
Save me.
But none of this is ever. See, he can't require anything out of you.
I've been gentle.
Would he break up with you if you wouldn't?
Huh?
That's a requirement.
But he
eventually, because the nigga, I don't give a, I don't care.
Like, would he break up? Would he break up with you if you didn't?
Yeah, I would. Because eventually, you're gonna get tired of your shit.
No one's leaving me right now.
Y'all break the show.
cockiness, nobody's leaving me alone.
What?
She said she cocky. Nobody
leaving me alone.
I never got left.
Now, I'm not difficult either.
Okay.
I'm really not difficult. So, like, and I'm, like, at the end of the day, I feel like...
Nobody ever left you?
I said no one's leaving me alone. That's what I said.
But niggas,
niggas don't leave.
Niggas, wait. No one's leaving me alone.
Niggas don't leave women alone. They don't leave chicks alone.
Understand this. A nigga say all this shit. A nigga say all this shit what he don't like about you. Right. But at the end of the day, he don't really be leaving you alone.
No.
He don't. No. I ain't even gotta call you.
And what do you think? What do you think that means?
The toxicity is very heavy. Yeah.
No, no. Sex is good.
You think, right. You want some more pussy. You think,
don't matter. He still ain't leave me alone.
All right, facts. But he's sticking around
but
for a reason.
At the same time,
that don't really mean
my
nothing.
My problem is the gift and the curse is I enjoy other people's happiness. So whoever I'm with, whether it's friends or in a relationship, I want to know what make you happy because...
You need to teach a fucking seminar on that because I don't know like, no other one. You need to teach a class on that shit.
Girl, like, I'm going to make sure you're smiling. Which you need?
You need to teach classes. I'm just speaking,
so it's my challenge to see what I could do to make sure you don't leave me alone.
Get into Steve's last topic.
You ain't going nowhere.
Steve, get into Steve's topic.
Talk all that shit.
I leave you every week, and you still here every week. Hey, Ryan.
All right, Steve, we got a little hour. We want to get into your story. Come on, tell us. Talk to us. Talk.
All right, so
hold up, Steve. Got a topic. Come on, let's go.
So to piggyback off of what Star said, right? You know what I mean, listen, it's not here I go. The beauty about friendship is sometimes. Honesty is important. So sometimes, I'm gonna tell y'all a story, right? Real quick. I was dealing with this girl. She was dealing with this ball playing nigga. I ain't gonna say his name. He was like 6'7".
Evan Turner.
The reason why I asked you to put the name out is because when we started the podcast, you said, I got stories. I could put names to them. I got ball players. So put the names to them then.
You ain't put no nigga name out.
Don't put the nigga name out there.
It's a ball player. Who gives a fuck?
He might have a wife now.
Even Biggie said he was playing Utah Jazz and I was in the ass while she was playing Utah Jazz.
Oh, shit. It was John Starks?
No, go ahead.
Hold on. All right,
go ahead. This is.
If it ain't got no names to it.
I just named the girl.
Nigga, dog, you dog.
Nigga, go ahead, tell a story, dog. Go ahead, tell it.
Barcast each and every Monday we have Crush Laugh.
Tell a story, nigga. Come on, go ahead. So what happened?
All right, so she was dealing with this ball playing ass nigga, 6'7", right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I ain't never slept with her, but then. We had a good night.
Oh, shit.
So hold on.
Oh, my God. This nigga about to. Dog, nigga, go ahead. We build up anticipation. Nigga, tell a story.
Listen. So I'm going to tell a story, right?
Right.
So, you know, I'm like, damn, this nigga 6'7", ball playing ass nigga. I'm 5'8".
Uh-huh.
Like. Oh, shit. I am 5'8".
This nigga, look at me. I'm standing right next to him. He said he 5'8". I'm sorry. This is his story.
Please
let him tell his story. He is 5'8" in this story.
Please, please tell a story because it gets this shit gets so much better. Please tell a story because the story gets better. Please go. This nigga.
So I'm like, all right.
It's his story.
Yo, Marissa.
Here's the term, story.
You know how tall I am. So anyway. So all I'm saying is.
Yo, can you please tell a motherfucking story, man?
I'm trying to tell a story.
Go ahead.
Why keep cutting me off?
Go ahead.
So I'm like,
you 5'8". Go ahead.
So Stop cutting me off. So, you know, we get together, we have a good night. You know what I mean? She get me right. You know what I mean? And when she get me right, instead of she's saying, no, what does that mean? I'm gonna explain to you. No, listen, because everybody keep cutting me off. You want me to tell it like I told you before?
All right, so. So
most women got two sizes. This is what the story want me to tell.
Uh-huh.
They got big and they got little. Right. This what big want me. This what he want me to tell. They ain't got no
in between.
No medium, no regular, no nothing. So the bottom line is, me and a young lady we got together. You know what I mean? She enjoyed herself. She mm-hmm. said, "Look, you perfect." I didn't know how to take that. Let me finish. On some real shit.
Right, she said you're perfect.
I'm perfect size.
I'm perfect. You're the perfect size.
Perfect.
You fit just right.
I don't get that.
Listen.
She said couch fits and shit like that.
So listen. All right, so we going to get to the... Look, we ain't... I'm not going to tell the story because y'all...
No, please keep telling the story.
It's a good story.
All right, keep telling the story. Go ahead.
What is this story?
The good story. No, but... listen. Here's the thing. Here's the thing.
Right.
Like I said, most women got two sizes. They got little and big, right? No. That is actually a good response. Or you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So here's the question for the ladies right over there. Star, Marissa, other ladies. Come on over here. You know what I'm saying? Listen, here's the thing.
They about to fuck with Steve's ego. Go ahead.
Go ahead. Ask the question.
Please ask that. I want to hear the women talk about this shit so bad. Go ahead, please. Go ahead. All right.
Is there a size and do the size matter when it comes to making love?
Yeah, absolutely.
Hell yeah. Oh, it's for the girls.
I know. Don't you fucking answer.
Hell yeah. Like,
go ahead.
Girls, what's up? She looked at the point, the mic away.
I feel like if it ain't knocking it out the box, it's not worth me putting mileage on the poom poom.
Okay.
So when we first meet y'all, right? And we're gonna be locking it up. We locking it up. And if it like grope my hand across and whatever, I get on top of you at the bar and I don't feel nothing. I'll be like, girl, I ain't feel nothing. So I gotta go out with you again. So when I go out with you again and we in the car, I gotta like kinda like touch and see. Mm-hmm. Because then that's gonna determine if I wanna go ahead and pursue you. Cause I'm not about the point of me trying to get in a relationship or something, I'm not being with nobody that's not carrying it. I gotta be all the way involved with you all the way around the board, mentally, physically, sexually. If you're not satisfying me,
the size is the only thing that's gonna satisfy you.
And I heard a lot of women say, a lot of women say that little dick niggas know how to work it, but he ain't for me.
She said she got a lot of little dick bodies on her.
Go ahead.
First and foremost,
that little dick shit ain't for me.
I disagree. Because first and foremost, you're not breaking down my sheetrock. You're not fucking up my walls.
If your pussy tight and it's poom is giving, it ain't never
yeah, but here's my thing. Like, no, that shit don't feel good.
No.
That shit don't always feel good. And that shit be like, what you about to do with that?
That's what I was
saying. I'm cool. But at the same time, I do. The weird part about it is, smaller men, if that girl love you, she gonna ride you like you LeBron James.
No.
She ain't gonna give a fuck. She gonna make excuses for you and everything.
I feel like I agree with Star, not too much of a small, but I know some guys with some big things and they can't stroke and they can't fuck. And then you got some guys with some RA sizes and they put in work. So it's like, it's not the size, it's the motion of the boat, because
that's what she meant by you perfect.
Like,
Because they think because they big, they don't got to do nothing. They think because it's big.
That's bullshit. No, that's bullshit. Because niggas, nah, well, I ain't never meet him. I ain't never met him. Because the men that I'm with, we get it the fuck in. That's it. We ain't doing all that. Play. What you doing? What we doing here?
All right, hold on.
You ain't carrying. We ain't doing it. That's it.
Listen. Let me say this. Hold up. Listen. I'm gonna put it to you like this. Shaq always gonna be the first pick, but the nigga can't make a free throw.
Okay.
He can't make a jump shot.
Uh-huh.
So so bigger don't always mean better. So, but Kobe Bryant is could do it all. Right. And that's the type of man that you want.
But I think I've been blessed. I've been blessed by the best, and that's all I'm gonna say.
See, I think it's also about what they used to.
Let's see what Mr. Toxic got to say.
Wait. You can talk that Shaq gonna be the number one pick, but he not. What, times has changed.
Hold up, what do y'all consider?
What's the answer y'all consider small?
After like six?
I can't say what a small dick is. That's y'all.
So what do you do? What do you Google the average?
No, wait. Hold on.
Like, I ain't gonna talk about that. Y'all ain't gonna be having people in my damn DM.
I forgot my point. What I was about to say. She cut me off.
In any argument, every man is a little dick nigga. But at the end of the day,
What happened?
Bitch, you never fix her lips to call.
You never gonna confuse.
Wait, no.
No, listen. Let me say.
Hold on.
Let me say this right. No, listen.
Yeah,
no, hold up, stop. Listen.
Oh my God, yo.
I really think so.
Every guy think they got a big dick.
Can I talk?
I think if a man hasn't seen a bunch of dicks, you like, all right, you know what I'm saying? Unless it's on porn.
Hold on, wait.
My dick ain't porno dick, but I know my dick is husky.
Oh
my God. You know what I'm saying? Like that's the difference. Right, but
What are we talking about? What the fuck are these niggas talking about?
Go ahead.
Women make the market on what's big and what's small, right? We can't, if it's up to us, our dick is the biggest, right? So, period. So, women make the market on what's big and what's small. But what I wanted to say is, you said big ain't always better and da da da. Shaq always gonna be the number one pick, but he can't hit free throws. Times has changed. There's a 7'4 nigga who can do everything. That's coming into the league, number one pick.
Yeah.
He can shoot threes. Yeah. He can fade away.
And he's a one in a million.
Yeah, that's one in a million.
Right.
That's Dirk Diggler.
But what I'm saying is, most girls want that.
But everybody ain't gonna get that.
Mr. One in a Million, how y'all doing?
And when a girl is fucking with a big dick nigga. No, whether the argument, she never gonna be like, you got a little dick. Never. That never comes out of her mouth. Ever.
Fuck you, nigga.
You heard that in a few arguments.
Let me say this. Hold on, first of all.
He don't carry that.
You lying. Because now you lose the argument because you're lying right now. Right? It's over because you're a liar.
You tell him everything you lying about. I love you so much. You're not never going to say, you little dick nigga. I hope you
what
die,
you
though. Hope you fucking
argument.
Die. Like, no, you,
you
never.
You liar. You never hear that damn mother.
Never.
I've never been called a little dick nigga.
First and foremost, because now it's relative to the person that's with it and whatnot. You ever notice that if you fucking a girl that like you or that's love with you or whatnot, and you don't even feel like you're giving 110% and she's screaming her fucking head off, back in your mind, you think, come on, bitch, you doing a little bit more.
We be lying.
You
know what
I'm saying?
We be lying.
No. I'm talking about lying.
We gotta stop doing that.
Nigga, you're not always killing this thing. Stop talking.
What?
That's little dick thinking.
You always killing this
thing. That's little dick thinking.
I'm not thinking, bitch,
listen.
Exactly.
Calm the fuck down.
Wait. I know that's confidence.
No,
look.
I'm always killing it. I'm gonna split the bitch in half. I'm the fucking man. Hulk smash.
Yo, what? Let me explain something to you.
Yo.
I gotta go to the bathroom.
When it comes to the ladies, right?
And, I'm standing for me.
You know, it's a, I'm going to the bathroom. I don't want to speak a lot of business out here. But all I'm saying to you is, when it comes to, it's only two sizes that the ladies got. They got little and they got big. It's no regular. You know what I mean? No, it is. No, it is. No, but y'all don't rep that.
Bitches say
your shit. Y'all don't rep that.
What's
the bottom line is.
We do rep it. It ain't the dumbass decisions we make and keep dealing with the dumb shit. Because we feel like. We don't feel like it's regular. We feel like it's perfect.
Y'all do dumb shit for a big dick.
Let me ask you a question. Let me ask y'all a question because
That's why, as Will would say, you be like, let me get $200. You be like, here you go. Yeah.
All right, Star. Wait a minute, Star. Time out. Star. We already know how Marissa feel.
So it's three.
Listen.
It's three.
And Maya, you too, and you as well. Is the biggest dick you have the best sex you ever had?
No. It was actually the worst.
That's
it. It was actually the worst. It was the worst sex I ever had.
Wow. What can you say? That's what I'm saying. You gotta take that for standard.
Unfortunately, I haven't had to agree because I've been told that. Yo, I agree with you guys.
All right, listen.
I'm crazy.
God damn it.
Like I said,
it was the worst.
Yeah, tell it with everybody.
No, tell your story.
Yo, can you please?
Little dick questions, man.
Go ahead, Steve.
We're not getting back into the story.
She said you perfect. That's it.
She said you perfect. It's cool.
I'm not getting back into the story.
Oh, all right.
Start it over then. The relationship. He was making love.
No, listen.
Making love.
I'm gonna be honest with you.
I don't have no problem.
You know how I feel. You know how I feel about everything. All that, you know, is beauty in the eye to behold. You perfect. That's for little dick. That's for the other shit. Because when you working with something and you pull down your pants, she either like go slow. Or what are you about to do with that? If you ain't never get that, you are in the little dick category. I'm just gonna tell you that. I'm gonna be honest with you. You are in the little dick category.
But if you fucking Janet Jackman, you can't really tell that. You know what I'm saying? If our pussy, if she done ran through everybody,
you can't really tell that.
You know what I'm saying? It's a lot of big pussies out here too, man. No matter how big her pussy is,
she's gonna acknowledge a big dick. I don't give a fuck how much of a whore she is.
Or she can lie and say you got a big dick when you don't. That's what I'm saying. Like, you know what I mean?
Ain't no girl lying about a nigga.
Women lie about a lot of shit, bro. Bitches will lie. They will lie, bro.
If a nigga got a bag, his dick just...
I know.
If a nigga got a bag... No. If a nigga got a bag and y'all trying to get to that bag, y'all gonna manipulate it. Y'all gonna say his dick big.
Agreed.
Y'all gonna say, even though that nigga 5'5", that he 5'8". Y'all gonna tell him what he wanna hear.
Yep.
You hear me?
Exactly. Yes.
Y'all gonna tell Steve what y'all wanna tell
him. Right. You perfect.
He's perfect.
No, listen. No,
God, he's perfect.
Let me say this to you.
Hold on.
Listen.
Go ahead.
Based on experience.
But Steve, you 5'8"?
Let me say this to you, right?
Go ahead.
Based on experience, right? When it comes to the ladies or whatever, most men know if they satisfy on the women based on their relationship after they had sex with.
What is he talking about?
Elaborate. Keep going.
Elaborate. First of all, it is not about the money.
Okay.
Because some people ain't got money.
They dicking him.
No.
They long dicking the bitch, and she's staying around. That's exactly if he broke in little dick, he's not staying around.
No, listen.
Come on now.
No. First of all,
broke in a little dick. Come on now.
Let me say something. First of all, B. Listen, B. Ain't none of your bitches been here yet, bro. Be cool, man. Be cool. What I'm trying to say is, when it comes to satisfying women, it ain't always about the size. It's not.
Okay.
It's about how you pleasure them. Now, what you want to say, and what everybody, what he want to say, and what some of the other brothers want to say, and what some of the people that's not here, I'm representing. No.
The little itty bitty committee.
No.
The itty bitty committee.
No. Yo, hold up.
Oh,
hold
this shit just said it's like giving a little dick energy. Stop. No. Steve, no, stop.
No. You set yourself up.
No. I'm not. Listen. All right,
go.
I'm going to show y'all something. And I'm going to teach y'all. It's all. Listen. The bottom line is.
Steve, you said.
Yeah, yeah. What you mean by that?
Absolutely.
So, you had great sex with somebody and they ghosted you, then what?
I'm good.
great sex and they ghosted you? I can't answer that.
Y'all say, you're saying that, oh, it's not about the size and this and the third. Let me say something. A woman, small poom poom, mini poom poom, whatever poom poom y'all got, I don't fucking know. If you're not satisfying her, y'all might have a good little vibe going on, but when she say, I'm going to fuck him, girl, I'm going to fuck him, and she fuck you, and you ain't fucking her the way she want to fuck, she on the phone with her girlfriend. She's talking about
you.
And then next thing you know, she might be, because you didn't nail it to the cross.
Right, so here's the thing.
You didn't carry.
Let me explain something to you, right?
Satisfying. Satisfying. So y'all mix. You eat her out. She do whatever she do to you. Then it's time. Are we worked up? We trying to have sex. You didn't got me all wet, and I have sex with you, and you ain't carry. Oh no, you will never again. She's talking about you now. I ain't that girl. That was the way.
Okay,
I put 25 miles on my poom poom for this little dick nigga.
Oh, okay. What I'm saying is, it's dykes out here that's turning women out, and they ain't got no dicks.
They pulling out that little strap. She ain't pulling out no 4-inch.
She ain't get pussy to Mars and back. What are you talking about? Like, carry this for me.
What I'm saying is, Larissa, at the end of the day, Star, I forgot her name. Maya. It's all about representing in the bedroom.
Don't pull the strap out,
Stan. See, strap self carrier.
That's it. Like, I don't want to speak people's business, but the bottom line is the regular size niggas is winning.
What he's trying to say is little dicks. What he's trying to say is, to sum it up, little dicks matter. That's all. Little dicks matter, like little asses, little butts. We matter. We matter. Little dicks matter. That's all. He's trying to sum it up. We love them. We love them.
What the fuck is going on in this podcast right now?
That's a fact.
Bless them all. God bless everybody differently.
That's crazy.
He got a question.
I ain't got no question.
What's the question?
That's some crazy ass shit.
Everybody's made differently. God is good.
God is good.
So you cut everybody off.
Cut everybody off like in him. Yes. Well, I'm not wasting my time. We getting old, not young.
Okay. I'll see you later.
This is so crazy. I am so
the party vibe is signing off, bitch. Y'all.
These
like,
niggas is crazy.
Each and every Monday we at Crush Lounge, man. We like to have fun.
Yo, we had an hour and 25. Y'all want to wrap
we
up?
Don't we don't argue. We done made up a family. I done seen his little PP before and everything, y'all. Like,
that was last episode. You still showing dick pics?
No, I'm live.
He all in my DM. He all in my DM.
No, I'm not. She lying.
That's why he know everything about my party by page, because he be watching me and shit. He thought he was roasting me.
Come on. Show the DMs. Go to our DMs right now.
Can we go to the next one?
I thought we DM each other.
Go to him. Show me him. Show me the DMs. See, girls just be talking.
Girls
just be talking.
No, y'all two do not sit next to each other no more. Because y'all like kids.
Listen.
But it's a vibe, though. He can't get me mad.
It's a
vibe.
He
gonna sweat, and I'm gonna
and
sweat.
And she gonna
little.
Say this little peepee. You know this dick, dude. Stop playing. Stop playing dead. Not feeling you saw this. I'm talking. You know.
I remember.
All right, we gonna do what this, we learned.
Oh, you don't remember, but on the live, you gonna say, I seen this little peepee.
All right, y'all, we running over time.
I thought you don't remember.
I don't remember shit like that.
We gonna do what we learned. I cut y'all mics off. We gonna do what we learned, all right? I'm going to start from that angle, from that area. Jesus Christ. Star, what have you learned today?
I've learned that little dicks matter. The kids. Fuck them kids.
Fuck them kids.
Not fuck the kids.
And I learned that if I was to die giving childbirth, y'all would say, fuck me.
Damn. He said that.
That's what y'all said.
Marissa, what have you learned?
No, the rest of y'all said fuck that girl too.
All I'm saying is follow me on Instagram, Party Bob 2, and God is good, be great, and that's it.
We need to be a part of your network because the episode that you was on last did great numbers. We need to keep numbers. Yeah. So
I'm just me.
And we appreciate
you. We're light skin go. Let's talk all this shit.
I don't know. That nigga didn't learn nothing.
Yeah, y'all can follow me on Instagram. I'm trying to get my other page back, but that's all I gotta say.
Well, what has your ass learned today?
I learned that these niggas be fretting hard as fuck, yo. It's crazy out here. This nigga went from 5'5 to 5'8. He perfect. No, tell a story how it went. You know what I'm saying? Keep it real. If you keep it real with these girls, they ain't got nothing. They can't call you out on nothing.
Oh, my gosh.
You know what
gosh.
I'm saying? Keep it a bing all the way.
Hilarious.
That's it. Keep it 100.
I learned that in 2022, Steve is still making love.
All
right, so give him a shout out for that. Thank y'all for coming out. This has been episode 11 of Barcast. Shout out to everybody that came out. Marissa, Star, Will the Therapist, my host B, Steve with his crazy ass. Shout out to Crush Lounge, Alibaba the Chef, bartenders, everybody. Love y'all. Peace. Emotional damage.